testing. Testing, testing, 1, 2. Testing. I can't hear anything. I'm not getting any feedback in the headphones. But I honestly don't know how to work this. Testing, 1, 2. Testing. Testing, 1, 2. Testing, testing. Testing. Yeah, I can't hear it in here, but it's picking up sound.
Is do you have left knob turned up?
The which one?
Because this is the left knob's the one that does it, right?
Testing, testing. Testing. Testing.
It's possible the feedback is just very low as well. I'm not sure.
Stuff.
Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. I can hear me. Oh, I'm live. Well, hopefully you can hear me. I'm going to do this sound check. It seems like everything is on. So we will be back here shortly in about 9 minutes to start this game off.
This morning?
Yeah.
No, they left early because they had class. We were not going to, no, T and D were going to get kicked out. The rest of us weren't going to get kicked out. I was doing good this morning.
T had it too. No, she got pissed off because we weren't, like, hustling at all.
Thank you.
card or something like that.
It's something like April 24th.
Responsibility, sportsmanship, and servant leadership.
All right, folks, welcome back to that same old place, the Trojan Battleground. That is Van Dixhorn Arena on the campus of TIU. It's time for another conference clash that will pit the now 13-3 TIU Trojans up against the Titans of IU South Bend. South Bend, a very interesting team. They were terrific last season, going 22-8 on the campaign, but off to a little bit tougher of a start this time around. They are currently 5-11, though they have won 3 of their 5 conference matches so far. For the Trojans, 13-3 on the year. Their 7-game win streak was snapped in a 4-set contest against Indiana University Kokomo outside of conference, but they got back on the horse strong, traveling to Judson University and knocking them off in straight sets. It'll be Lena Vujošević to get it going, the senior from Montenegro. As she always does, we'll start this thing off for the Trojans. More CCAC action from Van Dixhorn Arena. Vujošević strikes it down. The Titans with their first attacking chance, not too much on it, dug up by Jalen Freeman. The attack was from Alexis Hassett. Now Brianna Torres, the Trojan leading killer, rejected, but she will not be denied twice, and she gets TIU on the board in this one. Sorry for the little delay there, but IUSB evening up the score. 1-1 here in set number one. Felicia Campanello, the 6-foot-tall sophomore, will have the service here for the Titans. Barrels it over the middle. Freeman with the routine dig. Now Scripshock setting up Torres, led her a little too far in front. Now from the side, a set will attack again, and she just finds the empty floorboards in the middle there to put IU on top. So 2-1 in the early going here. The set is going to be somebody that IU will try to feed a lot on the outside there. We've already seen it a couple of times today, and she'll definitely have to be a point of emphasis for the Trojans. A great diving dig for Mackenzie Powell to keep it alive for the Titans. Now Scripshock setting up Torres down the middle. She's rejected there. A nice block by Abby Seeger. And a nice little run here for the Titans as they get the jump on the Trojans, 3-1. This one is hammered deep. Scripshock, and now blocked out in front is the talented freshman Teresa Romero on her first attack of the day. Romero has been fantastic at the start of her collegiate career, contributing right from the get-go and playing her way all the way into the Trojans' starting lineup. Here's Jalen Freeman now. This one partially blocked, but a good dig by Torres and Freeman as they'll keep it alive. Vujošević dumping it back over. Now miscommunication. As Wheeler gets the dig, the Trojans scrambling, but they manage to keep it up once more. Now here on the outside, a hard attack, but a dig by Freeman, just going a little bit too far there. Slammed by Macy Vondolowski. A lot of height on this IU squad, a lot of talented attackers, but the same can be said for the Trojans. Not the season so far that IUSB has been looking for, but this program has championship pedigree, there's no doubt about it. Dig by Freeman. Now here's Nadia Wheeler with her first go. And I believe a violation called on IU. So the Trojans climb a point closer. It's 4-3. Now Emma Gallegos checking in for the first time today for TIU. She'll batter this serve over. Dug up, and here's the attack and the kill for Seeger. So IU really taking advantage of the middle of the floor on the Trojan side. No doubt it's something that veteran head coach Luke Ward is going to address, and the squad will certainly pick up on it. No doubt about it. Now here's Madison Williams. And now on only the second hit, a clever play from Seeger as she'll bash that one over. So a nice start from Abby Seeger for the Titans, as the Trojans trying to settle into this contest a little bit. Here's Scripshock setting up Torres down the middle, and Torres with a bit of a misfire there. Whitney Gessinger back to serve once again. Scripshock setting up Torres, rejected but wide. So just too much power there from the all-world talent Brianna Torres as she gets the Trojans back in the score sheet here. Torres is one of the usual suspects for the Trojans, a fifth-year player from California who has picked up just about every accolade you could imagine in this game. As here is Madison Williams shoving this one down in front to score it for the Trojans. A clever play from the ever-efficient Williams. But of course, you've got the star setter, Anna Scripshock, who just picked up recognition last week with a weekly honor, and IU scoring here, too much on this attack here to be dug out, so 8-5. And of course, Jalen Freeman, the veteran who dons that white jersey, or whatever's the different colored jersey, every single night for the Trojans as their libero. She's terrific at just getting the ball back up into the air off an attack. Now this one rejected here. It's Williams out in front as it falls beyond the Titan wall to score a point for TIU. The Trojans beginning to fight back here. It's 8-6, IUSB with the advantage here in set number one. Madison Williams back to serve, looking to change that. Gessinger digs it out. Now here's the attack in front, and I believe in IUSB Titan careening into the net there, so the point to the Trojans, and they only trail by one here now. Williams back to serve it again, patiently waiting on the whistle, and now here she goes. Down the right side. A lot of juice on that one, and they'll only have to push it forward, but push forward in a nice spot. Great effort by Torres. Now a good effort to put it over by Lujoshivic. Somehow the Titans recover, but miscommunication and an errant set eventually gets to them in the scramble as Amber Jacobs is unable to climb the net with that one. So we're all knotted up here. The Trojans fell behind early, but they've rallied in this one. And the score stands at 8-all. Williams another serve. Now here's the attempt, and it barrels into the net. Point for TIU as Jacobs with her second consecutive error there on the outside. So TIU with their first lead in set number one since the score was 1-0. Williams having a nice run of service here. Puts it over the middle. Cheeky little push, but a great dive by Gallegos to salvage it, and the Trojans keep it alive. Now another great dig by Torres, but a violation called, I believe, rendering a couple of really athletic, impressive plays from TIU irrelevant in the end. So 9-9 in set number one. Mackenzie Powell for IUSB, dug up easily by Torres. Now Scripshock with plenty of time, and Vujoshivic blocked with the Trojan salvage. Now here's Torres firing from range, blocked down in front. So IUSB back in front in what's been a seesaw first set of this contest. Powell to fire it away towards the Trojans. Torres another dig. Scripshock setting up Romero. Tries to slice it across. Now this one fired away by Jacobs. The Trojans recovering. Vujošević. And it's going to be awarded to the Titans. It appeared as if a Titan may have got a touch on the ball, but the officials shooting a glance at each other and deeming that that was not, in fact, the case. So it will go down as an error for Vujošević by the slimmest of margins. And speaking of the slimmest of margins, this one is right on that line. A serve perfectly placed by Mackenzie Powell. And IUSB now out in front by three. Timeout is called. TIU is going to regroup. So IUSB jumping out in front early. The Trojans rallying back. But it's the Titans with the momentum once more. And the first timeout of the evening called by Coach Luke Ward. Coach Ward been doing this for a long time, his eighth season here with the Trojans. Recently eclipsed 130 career wins, and he could have a heck of a lot more than that by the time this season is done if the Trojans keep playing the way they have this campaign. He's got a great relationship with his players, there's no doubt about it. Always fascinating to watch pregame how he's got a different handshake for every single one of his players, and they'll go through that line, dapping him up in succession. And not just remarkable the chemistry, but also remarkable the fact that he can remember all that. To be honest, the Trojan roster, not terribly deep, but you've got nearly 25 players that each have got their own unique handshake. So a pretty cool gesture from Coach Ward, and really shows what he's about. Not just coaching a great volleyball team, which he has certainly done, but also just being a friend and a mentor to his players. Here's Mackenzie Powell to serve it once again as we're back in action. Over the middle, Torres the dig, and as the Trojans were scrambling on their end, it just falls into the floorboards there. So IUSB up by four, their bench going crazy. I don't know if I can even call it a bench because nobody's even remotely close to that bench right now. Now Scripshock setting up Romero. Romero with a little bit of touch, but just wide of the confines of the floor here. So the timeout not having any immediate effect as IUSB has established a 5-point advantage. Over the middle here, a nice kneeling dig by Freeman, setting up Vujošević, and not enough on that one. She tried to put some touch on it and just chop it over that very tall and stout front of IUSB that has held firm a lot of times on these blocks, so understandably trying to just punch it over, but not quite enough on that one. So 15-9 here in set number one. This one over the middle, another dig for the versatile Brianna Torres. Now Torres off the give and go, a great effort by IUSB just to keep that up as the ball plinkos around on their end. Just pure improvisation from the Titans. Now they'll see if they can get something going. Jacobs lobbing it over. Dug up by Isabella Acosta, the other talented freshman, getting her first action. Another impressive dig. How long can IUSB keep it alive? They dump it back down to the Trojans. Now here comes Romero, and finally the Trojans put it down. A beautifully placed strike from Teresa Romero, splitting the Red Sea, quite literally, of these red-clad Titans and getting the Trojans back on the board. Some remarkable efforts from IUSB, but all for naught as TIU eventually wears them down and has finally scored. Now here's Anna Scripshock, a dangerous looper in there. Barely recovering is IUSB. Nadia Wheeler pushing it over, and brilliant judgment from Wheeler. Just shoveling it over softly to find the weak spot in the Titan defense. The great baseball player Wee Willie Keeler once said that the strategy to hitting is to hit them where they ain't, and the same thing goes for volleyball, no doubt about it. Now this one blocked in front, back to the Titans. Another attempt for Jacobs, who they've been feeding with regularity of late. Torres will fire from deep down the middle, dug up by Gessinger. Now here's an effort out in front. Nice dig with palms up by Freeman, and now it's slammed down by Isabella Acosta. Acosta at that very deep outside hitter position for the Trojans. They've got a ton of talented players there. So unlike Romero, she hasn't found her way into the starting lineup yet, but the future is bright with Acosta waiting in the wing. She's been really impressive so far, as the Scrimshock serve will come up a little bit short. Though the Trojans do have some momentum back, no doubt about it. A lot of talented youngsters on this Trojan team, as Acosta thought she would check out momentarily, but she will still be out there, a pair of those talented freshmen in Romero and Acosta. And as deep as that outside hitter position is, Isabella Acosta has just played too well to keep on the bench, to put it frankly. She's carving out a nice niche for herself in year number one, and there's a miscue from Alexis Issette, the outside hitter for the Titans. And just a three-point Trojan advantage, as now Acosta will check out for the starter, Vujošević. The Trojan bench chanting. Not a huge crowd here tonight, but a decent student turnout and a decent bit of energy for a Tuesday night, no doubt about it. Now this one out in front, and just curled a little too far, and I believe that was Romero on the spot to jump on top of it. Now just a two-point advantage for the Titans. 16-14, here's Vujošević, one of the better servers on the Trojan team. This one blocked down in front by Torres and Romero, and the Trojans strike again. Just a one-point lead. The energy high as always, but it's been taken to a new level by the Trojan bench here as they chant, as Vujošević fires it up, and a little too much power on that one for the talented senior, who had a very nice stretch on the service there to get Trinity right back in it. Now Felicia Campanello set to serve it for the Titans. There it is. A low line shot, Scrimshock pushing it far across to Torres, who dots it up on the back line. A brilliant strike from Brianna Torres as she's starting to get going here. That combination of Scrimshock and Torres has been around for a long time here at TIU and has been doing great things pretty much as long as they've been here. Over the middle, this one very nearly caroming too far. Now here's Torres queuing it up and looping it. Diving effort by Issette to keep it up. As once again, not a lot of potency on the attack from IUSB. They were just defending, and they can't defend that one. So we are all knotted up here at 17 in set number one. The Trojans trailing a couple of times in the set, and they have bounced right back terrifically. A program showing their championship medal in a singular mindset, in pursuit of their first conference championship since 2006. Jalen Freeman set to go for the Trojans. Lobbing it down the middle. And the effort by Issette handled easily. Here's Wheeler queuing up a laser, but Powell digs it up. Now too much on this one. The effort from Campanello, so TIU is out in front 18-17 in set number one. Freeman trying to bring a spark in the service effort. Dangerous ball just past the net. This one out in front, diving effort off of the partial block by Williams, by Brianna Torres. She got a piece of it, but not enough to loft it back skyward. So 18 all in a nip and tuck set number one. Now Sydney Hanna checking in to serve for the Titans. Scrimshock setting up Wheeler, and that block cannot be controlled. Too much power on it, and good placement from Nadia Wheeler. She will check out after delivering the Trojans the point that gave them the lead. 19-18, and here comes Emma Gallegos to serve it for TIU. Gallegos down the left side, going at the newcomer, Hannah. But she answers the call this time. Seeger, however, out in front will not, as she smashes it into that net. So now a little bit of breathing room. Ever so slightly, the Trojans providing themselves a little bit of a cushion here. 20-18 TIU. Here's another setup, and this one struck brilliantly by Abby Seeger, atoning for her mistake on the prior play. Impressive mental fortitude as she's able to turn the page here. We'll see if the Trojans can get some momentum back their way. This one punched over. Nice dig by the libero, Vanderord. Now stuffing that one out in front, Torres, and the point to TIU. ...21-19 to the Trojans here. Isabella Acosta will check in. The Trojans trusting her in big spots here with set number one on the line. Now here's Torres with that leaping serve to Jacobs, and Jacobs sliced it a little bit wide, so another point to Trinity. TIU out in front by three, and it's timeout for IUSB. So after struggling out of their timeout and falling behind by as many as six, the Trojans have flipped this set on its head and claimed a 22-19 advantage.
Check a couple things, see if I can find it. I'll give it a go.
Or ask
if not, head down there and ask somebody. Okay. I'm sure Danielle knows what's up.
The sport of volleyball, of course, so terrific because of the presence of momentum, so many of these back and forth stretches, and that's been the hallmark of this first set, with IUSB going on a couple streaks to give themselves a couple of leads, the Trojans battling back, and the Trojans answering once more here, falling behind significantly, and now they are up by three and just 3 points away from icing away set number one in an all-important conference battle. The Trojans just one loss in conference, and that came in their conference opener to a talented University of St. Ambrose team. They've got their eyes on the prize, looking for their first conference championship in more than a decade and a half. Here's Torres with the serve, and a little too far that time. So 22-20 TIU, still with the advantage. Both these squads bringing so much energy. Smiles all over the place. Just both teams, despite the intensity of this match, genuinely having a lot of fun out there. Here's Skripchak setting up Williams. And now this one's battered down, and a nice dig. Great reflexes by Jalen Freeman. Firing from deep is Torres, but it's dug up by Powell, who will now loft it back down to TIU. Skripchak setting up Acosta. She's blocked. Another great fisting dig from Freeman. Now IUSB scrambling. Gallegos finding a way to dig it up, and it slides into the net, and not much that you can do about that, as the Trojans tried to work it out of there. But the net just sucking the life out of it and making it very difficult to do so. Freeman, another dig. Skripchak will try to just punch it over, looking for the kill here. Now Freeman setting up Torres from deep, and Torres with perfect placement there to restore order and put the Trojans up 23-21. So the veteran Torres taking a little off at that time to up her precision and find the right spot just over that imposing Titan wall of blockers. Now this serve too deep. So a service miscue from TIU, keeping the Titans right in it. 23-22, and here comes Mackenzie Powell, who is very effective in a service effort earlier in set number one. We'll see if the Trojans can stifle her this time. Powell down the middle. Dig by Acosta. Acosta will have a go at it, and a brilliant strike from Isabella Acosta. So the freshman stepping up in a huge moment for TIU and putting them 1 point away from winning the pivotal set number one. It is set point, and the veteran Skripchak back to take it for TIU. Skripchak firing this one in, a line drive this time. Now this one chopped over, Skripchak digging it up. Freeman setting up Wheeler. Wheeler for the set, and off the side of her hand. Maybe a little bit of indecision on that strike from Nadia Wheeler, as she perhaps thought about trying to slice it across instead of just bashing it in there as hard as she could. But either way, the Trojans still have an opportunity to claim the set right here. Skripchak backpedaling, setting up out in front, Teresa Romero, and the freshman showing the skills of a veteran as she just pops that one down calmly right down the middle in the unoccupied space, and the Trojans outlast the Titans in set number one, 25-23. So a thrilling back and forth set to open the contest, and the Trojans really showing their resilience that has enabled them to put together their terrific 13-3 campaign so far. This is a team that really never gives up, never takes their foot off the gas, even when they're struggling a little bit. Found themselves facing a pretty imposing margin towards the middle of the set. But that's when they really started to click on all cylinders there to salt it away. So set number one in the books, if you're just joining us, the Trojans getting the jump on IUSB by winning that set 25-23, a hotly contested battle where IUSB led by as many as six in the middle of the set, but the Trojans rallying towards the end to claim a slight advantage and parlay it into a set victory with the talented freshman Isabella Acosta and Teresa Romero giving a big boost to TIU late. Both recording late kills, with Romero's being the ultimate decider on their second set point to prevent a 24-24 deadlock that would have forced the scenario where one team would have to score two consecutively to win the set. Well, there's the horn, and set two action is imminent. The Trojans looking to start a new win streak here after their seven-gamer was snapped recently. They did win their last contest, a conference battle against Judson University, in convincing fashion, picking up that W in straight sets. This Indiana University South Bend squad not having the year that they've wanted to have so far. They're 5-11 on the campaign, but they are 3-2 in conference, and a team that finished with a 22-8 mark last time around. So they're a program with some championship pedigree and a team that is certainly dangerous, as they demonstrated in this first set. Standing in the center of the metaphorical ring and going toe-to-toe with this talented Trojan team right from the get-go in an extremely close set number one. A rare moment of relative quiet here at Van Dixhorn. Not a ton of fans making a ton of noise tonight, but both these teams are bringing a lot of energy. As here is Amber Jacobs, set to get set number two started for IUSB, and there's that energy once again coming from the Trojan bench. Dig by Freeman, set by Skripchak, setting up Romero. She's rejected, but the play will continue here. Freeman, now Torres with another go from deep. IUSB finally able to corral. Isabella Acosta out there to start set number two with that dig. Lofted over by Wheeler. Here's a push here and an athletic effort by TIU to keep that thing up by Acosta and Skripchak. Now Freeman laying out, the Trojans just finding a way, and they eventually whittle down the resolve of the Titans and get on the scoreboard first. Now Lena Vujošević. Terrific in the service, but she does way more than that. A fantastic striker as well for TIU on the outside. She'll hammer this one down, but a little bit short.
You got it with the camera as well?
Yeah. Just back.
Yeah, just a little bit to follow the ball, whichever side it's on.
So the ball back in the hands of IUSB. The talented setter, Skripchak, giving it to Wheeler, but not enough juice on that one. We've seen that a couple times from Nadia Wheeler. Just perhaps thinking a little bit too much out there. IUSB has had a lot of successful blocks, and that's something that's going to make you think twice about whether or not to slam it or to lob it over. And I think Wheeler on a couple of occasions has just been caught in between. Dig by Freeman, she makes it look easy again, and speaking of that, this one is hammered by Brianna Torres. Just too hot to handle there. IUSB was in perfect position to get a dig there, but simply too much momentum on it. There's not much you can do when Brianna Torres gets a hold of one. Now IUSB scrambling to keep it up. Isette puts it over. Skripchak with a long setup of Torres, who scores again. So the duo of Torres and Skripchak really showing what they're capable of and what they've done for a long time here for TIU. Anna Skripchak, the primary setter and pretty much the only setter here on TIU's team, sometimes goes a little unnoticed with some of her teammates and their terrific plays. But she just puts it right where her hitters need it. On that occasion, Wheeler had it where she wanted it, but was just denied there. The ball rifling back towards her, and that just shows the power on the strike of Nadia Wheeler. But unfortunately, that power was reversed back upon herself on that occasion, and rare to see a spike that hard be rejected. So props where it's due to IUSB. Now here's Madison Williams, typically ultra efficient, but she is unable to put this one over the netting. So IUSB out to a 4-3 lead. Sydney Hanna will serve it for the squad in red. Another dig for Freeman. And now this one put down by Torres, though I believe she got a piece of the net on the effort there. So a solid strike from Torres spoiled. And IUSB trying to find just a little bit of momentum after dropping a very tight set number one. Now here's Madison Williams gliding up to smash it down. Now Skripchak the dig. Here comes Torres firing away to finish it once more. Brianna Torres is on her game for the Trojans tonight. Torres, so fun to watch. Tremendous power, but she's a technician as well. There's no doubt about it. Her placement is also second to none. And she's just a brilliant hitter all around for these Trojans. Now IUSB finally finding a way to work it over. Here's Madison Williams shoveling it down into the vacant corner. So we're all knotted up now at five apiece. Williams didn't have the perfect angle to strike it, so just focusing on placing it exactly where she wants it, and turned out to be a very prudent decision there. Now here's a long-range strike dug up by Gallegos. Strip shot trying to force it over, but she is stuffed by the Titans, who get back on the board to take the 6-5 lead. Scripshock, of course, known as a dangerous setter and has plenty of dangerous hitters, so sometimes she'll just try to shovel that set over, instead turning it into an attack and try to catch the defense off guard. Usually works, but not on that occasion. Torres trying to force that one through, but IUSB holding firm, and now I believe a double touch violation called. So the Titans have a 7-5 advantage. Boy, we've seen some crazy celebrations from the Titans. They've certainly got a lot of positivity as Torres slams that one down to reduce the Titan lead to one. But you had a player standing on top of another player who was laying on the ground, almost mimicking a surfboard, a human surfboard. So IUSB definitely getting creative, and got to give them credit. They're having a lot of fun tonight, as are your Trojans per usual. Good vibes all around here at Van Dixhorn. This one slammed down by Amber Jacobs, but a little too much on it. So the Trojans will capitalize on the miscue, and we're all knotted up at seven. A terrific match so far, both sides showing what they're capable of, and have been pretty much each other's equal so far in this contest. Push down, Gallegos the dig, strip shot, setting up Torres from deep. A nice effort to keep it up by IUSB, and they do work it on down. Miscommunication, but they salvage it, and there's Madison Williams. TIU claiming the lead. Williams, a player who is sometimes overlooked due to the dangerous big-name players on this Trojan side, but she's tremendously efficient, always has a really high hitting percentage for these Trojans, and you can always look to her when you need a clutch kill. And speaking of, now Williams walling up in front to record the block. But I believe was unable to convert, so IUSB will take the point, and it's 8-all. The libero, Van der Oord putting it over. Scripshock setting up Williams, who rises and fires quickly. Back on down to the Trojans. Here comes Acosta, and this one a little bit wide, so a rare miscue from Acosta, who's been terrific this game and this season for TIU. And IUSB now out in front, 9-8. Set number two, the Trojans claim set number one. Looking to do the same here. Now here's a deep set for Torres. Torres with a nice dig there on a blistering attack, and the Trojans recover as Freeman dumps it on down. Now set up once more are the Titans, but this one sliced wide. I believe it was Jacobs firing it up. As now another outstanding freshman, the starter Romero, checking in as Jalen Freeman will get a break. So a couple of freshmen and plenty of veterans out there for the Trojans, including now serving Desiree Passono, who records the ace for TIU. Passono has really found her niche here with the Trojans in the service game. First time we've seen her tonight, but she'll check in to serve very frequently here, and one of the true specialists at it. Can come off the bench and deliver you quality service in the blink of an eye. Now here comes Acosta out wide. Diving effort by Whitney Gessinger to keep it up. Now this one slammed by Jacobs, but a little bit too far. And TIU out in front by 2, 11-9. Timeout IUSB. So TIU has restored order in short order, and they've got an 11-9 advantage in set number two. It really has been a season of destiny for these Trojans so far. Not a lot of times that you will see a team pick up 5-game and 7-game winning streaks right off the bat in the season. I believe it was in their first 14 games. They picked up a winning streak of 5 immediately after dropping their opener. And then after losing in a tough, heartbreaking 5-set loss to St. Ambrose, they rattled off victories in their next 7 contests. So these Trojans have been on fire all season long. They have yet to lose back-to-back games, or matches rather. And they're looking for their 14th victory in 17 contests so far. IUSB, however, not to be overlooked. And they've been fighting and keeping it very close all night. Here's Passono to serve it. The dig a little too far. And Romero's eyes lighting up as she tries to batter it down, and the Trojans eventually securing the point as it's mishandled out deep by IUSB. So Passono providing a jolt off the bench in the service effort for the Trojans. She'll rise and fire again down the middle. Now this one shoved out in front. Gallegos with the routine dig. Here comes Acosta queuing up the strike and clobbering it through the IUSB attempt. So the Trojan streak continuing undeterred by the timeout. Passono firing it again. Dug out and now slammed down in front by Campanello. So South Bend back on the board for the first time in a long time. Now perhaps a bit of confusion here with substitutes as Passono will check out to a well-deserved bunch of high fives from her teammates as her streak of service really getting this TIU team right back in the mix here in set number two and, in fact, out to an advantage. Now here's Acosta with another kill. The steely-nerved freshman just staring down multiple blockers and saying, "You can't do a darn thing about this." You have to love the confidence, and even more, you've got to love the ability of the freshman to just bash through those blocks. This one dug out, now out in front for Romero. A diving effort by Vanderord to keep it alive, but here's Nadia Wheeler. Another dig from Vanderord, the libero. Now blocked out in front, and I believe the net was hit there. So one of those points, we've seen a couple of them where TIU's just been wearing down IUSB, but that's the first one that really hasn't gone the Trojans' way, some way, somehow. Now a nice reaching dig by Acosta, shoveling it forward is Scripshock, but Nadia Wheeler with a little too much juice on that one. So South Bend trying to crawl back into set number two. This one down the middle, dug up by Freeman. Now Romero, she's turned aside. The Titans trying to get something going with the set. And apparently right on the line there. That was very much borderline. But the officials deeming that it did in fact catch some piece of that green line back there. So just a 1-point Trojan lead But the momentum hopefully shifting back over to the team in black as the serve comes up a little bit too short here. Now some confusion with the substitutions here as the official didn't catch that one. Acosta a little too eager to hop off and allow Vujošević to get in. Got to love the selflessness of a lot of these Trojan players, understanding the rotation, the plans of Coach Ward. You never see somebody come off and really do anything without a smile on their face and welcoming their new teammate into the ball game here. Now here's Torres queuing up a shot down the sideline, but coming up a little bit short there. The net holding firm, and now just a one-point Trojan advantage, 15-14 TIU. Here is Felicia Campanello. She's had a nice presence up front all day for the Titans. Now here's Torres! Some of these strikes from Torres have just been unbelievably hard. Surprised they haven't been followed by a sonic boom on a couple of occasions, because when she really gets her momentum going towards it and gets behind it, there's nothing anyone in this conference or really in this nation can do about it. Now here's Wheeler with the push forward. Here's a set on the side. Easy dig by the veteran Freeman, setting up Torres. Managing to handle it as IUSB, but another side-winding dig now by Freeman. Now pushed over, and the finish recorded by Brianna Torres. So the many sides of Bree Torres coming out here when she's finally rejected on one of those high-flying, hard-hitting shots. She takes something off and just finds the unoccupied space on the floor. Now a diving effort by Wheeler to keep this one up. Torres, it's blocked and back to the Trojan side, and now they're going to rule that it was in fact into the net, which I believe was the correct call there, as there wasn't quite enough on the recovery effort from Torres, but nonetheless, a sensational diving dig from Nadia Wheeler off the partial block. All these Trojans play with a lot of hustle, a lot of intensity. Never see anyone lollygagging it out there, that's for sure. As this one mishandled here, was in a tough spot for the setter Skripshak. And the Trojans are unable to force it back up, so timeout TIU. Coach Ward will have a word with his team as he tries to coax them forward to a victory in set number two. So these Indiana University South Bend Titans, with their backs to the wall here in set number two, finding a little bit of a surge here to put some pressure back on the Trojans. There really are not a lot of pushover teams in this conference whatsoever, and IUSB certainly isn't one of them, despite the fact they've gotten off to a bit of a slow start this year. They could still certainly be a player in the conference tournament come the end of the season, or even perhaps in the regular season title. They only have two losses. But for their title hopes, this would pretty much seem very close to a must win. Whereas the Trojans, well, they are doing quite well in conference play. Every game certainly has some added magnitude with a lot of these conference thoroughbreds with either zero or one loss. St. Xavier, St. Ambrose, St. Francis, some of the really historically great names in the conference. And that explains why the Trojans, despite having some solid squads, haven't claimed that conference crown in quite some time. They may have the squad to change that this season. Skripshak setting up Torres, and the official on the side having to duck with that thing flying off the hands of Sonia Vanderord, who had the futile task of trying to dig out the Torres strike. Now Emma Gallegos, the versatile senior, checking in. A blistering serve there. That's one of Gallego's strengths, but IUSB recovering and recording the finish here. So the Trojans 18 and South Bend 17. Both of these sets have been neck and neck the whole way. Williams with the routine dig. Here comes Torres, and just slicing it a little bit, perhaps off the side of her hand. So Torres, a rare attacking error, as she tried to get clever with it and just slightly miscalculated. Now this one climbing the net. Torres putting it back over, but not able to get too much force behind that one. Same with that Titan strike. Now here's Vujošević from deep. Dug out by Gesinger. Now this one is slammed out in front by Abby Seeger. Skripchak trying to save it off of the block attempt, but couldn't do so there. The Titans breaking out some more quirky and creative celebrations as they've got the lead here. And they will score again. I believe a violation on one of those hits there. Coach Ward not necessarily agreeing with the call, having some words with the official, who I believe called that the ball was more caught and pushed up than struck in one motion. A little bit of controversy, but it's water under the bridge now. IUSB is up by two. Skripchak setting up Torres. This one into the rafters off the dig and caroming into the seats. Boy, you've got to give some respect to Vanderoor just for stepping in front of some of these absolute missiles being unleashed by Brianna Torres. But it's no shame on her that she's not been able to do too much with them, as Torres has unmatched power on those strikes. Now this one dug out by Freeman, a good effort by Jalen Freeman, frustrated with herself that she couldn't get it up. But that would have been a sensational dig. Of course, we've become accustomed to seeing some crazy things out of Freeman, who I like to say she treats the ball like it's got an allergy to the hardwood and just will not let it hit there by any means necessary. Terrific digger for TIU. Now here's Madison Williams queuing up the shot. Blocked, but errantly so. Too much power on that effort from Madison Williams, who doesn't get too many kills for TIU, but when you need a big one, you can always look to her. She's remarkably efficient. And now the Trojans, trailing by one here late, will try to kindle up a spark from Desiree Passaono. She was fantastic in service earlier in this set with several straight points, but too much juice on this occasion. And IUSB now out in front 22-20 after the service error. The Trojans awaiting the substitution as Jalen Freeman will check back in. Passaono and Madison Williams hitting the bench. Here's the strike by Mackenzie Powell. Skripchak setting up Acosta. She's rejected, but good reflexes by Gallegos to keep it alive. And now a little bit of a second guess here from Acosta, as she tried to size that one up, but a little bit of last minute indecision. And South Bend is up 23-20 in set number two. The Trojans calling timeout with their backs to the wall in set number two, trying to claim the first two sets of this contest. IUSB trying to deny that. Boy, when you look at the stats so far in this one, it has been pretty much dead even in just about every major category. Both of these teams well constructed and showing their prowess in a lot of different areas here tonight. The Trojans trying to dig deep. Madison Williams giving some passionate words to her teammates here in the huddle. You love to see that leadership coming from all types of players up and down the Trojan roster. Williams just a sophomore on a squad with a lot of veterans, but great to see a player like her taking on that leadership role, which is really delegated to so many different Trojans as they really see themselves as a cohesive unit. an incredibly even match so far. IUSB has scored 46 total points, and the Trojans have scored 45. The Trojans, however, did claim that first set. IUSB looking to salt away the second, but they've got some work to do. Here we go. Mackenzie Powell, who had some service success earlier, will loft it over. Acosta with the dig. Now here comes Torres, and she snipes the back line. Boy, you couldn't have walked out there and plopped the volleyball down any better. That was pinpointed in a high leverage spot. Torres with no fear as she spots it right on the line. So the Trojans turning to their star veteran player to get them a key score late. Now Skripchak turning it loose on the service, but a little too far. So a couple of late service errors from TIU have IUSB just 1 point away from claiming the set. The Trojans encouraging each other on their side as they will try to find some resolve and fend off the Titan charge. Now this one slammed down by Vujošević, but a nice dig by Powell. It's lofted over. Torres the dig. Now this one punched over by Romero. Diving effort by Van der Oord, but unable to get it back over the net are the Titans, and TIU has their 22nd point of the set. Two sets away from forcing the need for two consecutive to win the set for either side. It's 1 point at a time. Vujošević putting it over. Powell scrambling. Here comes Campanello. She gets it over, but it's handled by Vujošević. Here comes Torres with some loft. They do dig it out. Now out in front, the attack and the kill for Campanello. So set number two is in the books. And IUSB striking back. We are knotted up at one. You could easily look at the record and think that this IUSB team was going to be a pretty easy victory for the Trojans, but anybody who knows about that program knows that certainly wouldn't be the case. A team that's had a recent coaching change, their coach, Allison Drzinski, in her first season at the helm. But she has certainly got her team playing at a high level right here, and it's going to be a battle for the Trojans. They've faced adversity a couple of times this year, no doubt about it. And they've bounced back admirably on most occasions. So we'll see how they answer the call here after dropping a very tight set number two. Through two sets, these teams have been extremely equally matched. I mean, just tremendously so. The first set going the way of the Trojans by a 25-23 margin. And IUSB with only slightly more breathing room as they claimed the second set by a 25-22 score. So we have not had anything lopsided or any sort of a blowout set so far in this one. It's been extremely tight the whole way. At times we've seen one team manage to create a lead of maybe five or six, but that's been about it, and it seems like whenever that margin's been reached, the opponent has gotten the memo and reached a new level and just comes surging back. So we have got ourselves a good one. It's TIU one set and IUSB one set heading into a pivotal set number three that will give its victor a chance to salt things away in set number four. We'll see who manages to break the deadlock. If anyone's able to push past just a razor-thin advantage and grab this one convincingly, or if it's going to be another nip and tuck battle from start to finish. Well, there's the horn. We're about to get started. Coach Ward still talking to his squad, showing a lot of passion. Is Coach Ward not sure if he saw some things he didn't like, or is certainly just trying to ignite a spark under these Trojans. But a lot of good energy from TIU per usual. Well, we are just about ready to rumble here in set number three. Both teams sensing the urgency here, as the libero, Jalen Freeman, will come on. The libero, Vanderord, also checking in for the Titans. And these brief moments before the sets, after the music over the loudspeakers is shut off, sometimes, some of the very few times that you can really have a moment of relative quiet and focus here in Van Dixhorn, because the energy is just consistently so high here. Even on a night like this where there's not too many fans in attendance, the players really on both teams bringing so much positive energy, as this one is shoved forward by Alexis Issette, who records the first kill of set number three to get IUSB on the board. We've seen a lot of squads with a lot of energy come into Van Dixhorn, but I'm not sure that anybody has had as much energy as this Indiana University South Bend team. They're just going crazy out here, just really enjoying themselves, as do the Trojans typically, as they will there on the kill from Nadia Wheeler to even it at one. But just some crazy antics we've seen from the Titans. Just almost goofy, like just very loose out here. The Trojans maybe not quite on that level, but of silliness at least, but they've certainly got all that energy and all those positive vibes. The Titans strike here to make it 2-1. This TIU team, always fun to watch because they've got a level of focus while they're having fun that is a pretty delicate balance, but something they really do a great job at under Coach Luke Ward. Now Skripchak setting up Torres. She'll try to shovel it forward. Now here's Wheeler having a go at it, but she's stifled in front. The joint block from Issette and Abby Seeger. So IUSB up 3-1. Now this one over the middle. Skripchak setting up Wheeler. Wheeler with some touch, but a good play coming in from behind by Seeger. But it's all for naught as the Trojans will score it. It's 3-2. Now Wheeler will get a break after an eventful first couple of plays. And here comes Emma Gallegos. She's the backup libero to Freeman, but when Freeman's healthy and ready to go, she's terrific in the service effort, as the Trojans will convert that one on the errant strike and knot it up at 3. Gallegos sending it down there once more. Now Issette, but not too much on that one. Torres, same can't be said for that strike, but they do block it now. Skripchak with the clever little shovel over. And a little bit of good fortune for IUSB as Seeger drills it into the top of the net. But it's redirected by the strands of it. And just falls on that dead wood toward the left side of the Trojans. Now the dig by Williams. Williams off the give and go. Good effort by Skripchak to keep it alive. But it is down to IUSB. Here is Jacobs. She's walled up in front. She'll have another go at it. Good effort by Torres and Freeman. Just to get a hand to it. But it careens into the seats here. It's the Titans 5 and the Trojans 3. Ujo Shivik receiving the dig. Now here's Torres with some loft. Couldn't time it up quite right. That one not with too much force either, and that one is hammered. But they block it, and Freeman with a great recovery. IUSB will just have to put it on back down, and now Williams free to fire, and it was deflected before it goes out, so the Trojans score it. And I believe they're actually going to rule it to IUSB. I thought that had tipped off the fingertips of one of the players in red there, but apparently not. Now here's Torres with another effort. Now the shove down by Skripchak, and I believe they're going to call a double touch on that. As it was a pretty forceful shove trying to reach the back, so it's possible that Anna didn't grab it simultaneously with both hands or was in contact with it for too long, but an interesting call. Not sure if it was the right ruling there. Now here's Williams as a little bit of miscommunication from TIU as she just had to improvise and try to get it back down. But IUSB is out in front 8-3, and Coach Luke Ward has seen enough. He's going to try to break up the momentum here with the Trojans down big early in set number 3. Well, we saw this in set number 1. In fact, even later in the set, the Titans of IUSB had a fairly substantial advantage, and the Trojans just found a way to dig deep and counter. They rallied from down by 6 in the middle of that set to establish a slight advantage late, and then salt away the set victory by a 25-23 margin. So there's still plenty of hope and plenty of time for TIU. Set number 3, one of the most important sets in any volleyball game, especially when it's knotted up 1-1. The swing in win probability and morale can be tremendous. So Coach Ward, sensing the urgency in this set, sensing that his squad was falling behind a little bit, and trying to nip the IUSB stretch right in the bud and get his team back on the score sheet. We'll see if the ploy pays off here. Whitney Gessinger is back to serve it. The Trojan bench chanting once more, lots of energy. Once again, as they'll try to get back on the board here, punched forward by Torres. Now this one shoveled into the middle skillfully by Mackenzie Powell. That's a play we've seen from Skripchak time and again this season, and Powell taking a page out of her book to record a kill from that setter position. Now this one slammed forward but unable to corral it as Williams records the kill. Also checking in is Madison Fagans to give Skripchak a little bit of a rest here. Fagans also a very competent setter for the Trojans. Of course, they have got a star in Skripchak though, so playing time on occasion is few and far between for Fagans, but that does not mean she is not tremendous at what she does. Too much juice on this one, but the Titans saying that the Trojans had a player touch it, but the referee is not ruling that to be the case, so TIU scoring it. We've seen a couple of plays where it's been up for debate if anyone's gotten a hand on it. But this one going the way of the Trojans after the last one didn't. And now clobbered down by Abby Seeger as the Trojans are unable to stifle it on the block. So South Bend out in front, 10-5 now. We'll see if TIU can string a few together. Dig by Acosta, wandering over. Now Jacobs will have a go at it and pinpoints it on the back line. It's a party right now on the IUSB bench and on the floor as well. They've played very well here in set number three, but it's far from over, especially against this talented and resilient Trojan side. Vanderord puts it over. Acosta's dig on the money this time. Torres will blast it from deep, but not too much steam on it. Jacobs dug out nicely by Freeman. A great dig to set up Acosta, who fires a bullet that was ticketed for the face of Whitney Gessinger if she didn't manage to at least get a couple of hands on it. But the only consequence of her getting those hands up there was to protect herself, as it just had too much gusto on it. And in fact, found its way all the way to the seats that are a good maybe 20 feet back from the edge of the court. A tremendous strike. And now this one is perfectly placed here in front of a diving Trojan to keep IUSB up by double the Trojans' margin out here early in set number three. Couple of substitutions for TIU. It is Powell to serve it for the Titans. Lobs it over. Here's Fagans getting some extended run and setting up Acosta. And Acosta running into the net, I believe, here. So IUSB taking advantage. Couple of rare Trojan miscues here. Fagans, as this one is barely shoveled over, playing some tic-tac at the net. And eventually the Trojans are victorious in that little cat and mouse battle that never strayed more than a yard from the net. So TIU recording the score as Scripchak comes back in for the service. Fagans coming in and seeking to provide a spark. She played well in that little stint, no doubt about it. But Scripchak is back in for TIU. Now the Trojans keeping it alive, and a little two-handed push pass by Nadia Wheeler. Tremendous improvisation from Wheeler as she turned an effort that seemed like the main objective would just be to get it back over the net into a very dangerous shot, resulting in the kill. Now this one with plenty of loft on it from Scripchak, but not quite enough distance. Scripchak likes to employ that change of pace off the serve, but it can be tricky because you've still got to hit it with enough force to get it over the net. But she's got a lot of deceptive service looks. Nice dig from Acosta. There's Torres right on the line. Beautiful strike from Brianna Torres. And this has really been a master class from her, not just in terms of the power she's been getting on some of these, but just perfect placement on some of these efforts, as she has been undeterred by the prospect of wandering wide of that green line, pinpointing a couple on the sideline and the back line alike. Now Scripchak getting a hand to it, but unable to control it, and South Bend scoring here. So IUSB maintaining a fairly significant advantage, especially with how tight that these sets have been so far. The first two sets being split by margins of 2 and 3. Those are the margins of victory. And trying to make this one close as well is Brianna Torres, as that smash in there will reduce the deficit to just 5. The Trojans within striking distance, but they'll have to string a couple points together soon. The ball in play once again, and here goes Jalen Freeman. IUSB scrambling, but an unsuccessful block in front by Torres and Williams, who tried to stuff it. Checking in briefly there was the transfer, the newcomer, Halsey Keltner. She's flashed some promise on the outside as well. But the Trojans are so deep there, so many competent options. And one of those, Nadia Wheeler, the Trojan starter, will check back in. Now here's Torres queuing up a bullet. The Titans recovering for the moment, but unable to corral it cleanly and force it on back down. So a couple of snipes from Torres here have helped the Trojans remain within striking distance in a pivotal set number three. Now the dynamic senior, Emma Gallegos, free to fire on the service, but too far down the left sideline. So South Bend 17, TIU 11. It's been fairly even since that timeout, but the early IUSB advantage still standing up for the moment, and now a rare bit of miscommunication between the Trojan stalwarts, Scripshock and Torres. Normally those two are always on the same wavelength, and it's been a tremendous combo here in Deerfield for a variety of different seasons. IUSB recovering and shoveling it back down. Now here comes Torres, she's blocked. Freeman falling away, unable to recover. So a rare time that we see Torres denied at the doorstep. And IUSB's lead has ballooned to an 8-point advantage. Here's Torres trying to chop it in the middle. Powell's able to reach over and grab it. Now Powell firing. And not sure if that was touched by a Trojan. I believe that's the call, as it had a lot of juice, but did take a deflection apparently. So 20-11, though this serve will come up a little bit short from Gessinger. So perhaps some life for TIU, trailing by 8 late in set number 3. And if you're going to turn to anybody, this is exactly who it should be. Brianna Torres back to serve, the 3-time first team All-Conference and former All-American. Slammed in front, but the Trojans keeping it alive. Scripshock setting up Acosta. And somehow the Titans fending it off. Scripshock now will set up Torres, who blasts it. Too hot to handle for the libero of the Titans, Van der Oord, as that thing was sent careening to the back of the gym with a ton of momentum on it. Only a 7-point advantage now. The Trojans seeking to cut into it once more, and this one is a little bit wide on the effort by Abby Seeger. The Titan advantage is down to 6. We knew they'd need to string some points together. Is this the time they'll be able to do that? Torres another serve. Now they set up Seeger again. And Torres free to fire once more, and it finds its way to the hardwood. Another kill for Brianna Torres. Now a brief delay here. The senior setter of IUSB, Mackenzie Powell, having some words with the official. Not sure what about, or maybe just a bit of veteran gamesmanship there, trying to stall the Trojan onslaught here. We'll see if it works. Here's Jacobs, dug by Freeman, nearly to the rafters, but not quite. Acosta and Gallegos will shove it back down. Now this one slammed out in front and does reach the floor eventually, as Seeger records the kill, and IUSB is up by 6. So the Trojans showing signs of life. They're going to need one heck of a stretch, though. if they're to win set number three. Williams slamming it into the wall. Good recovery by Scripshock and Freeman. Now laying out full extension by Vanderort. Both sides with some Houdini-like acrobatics to keep this thing alive. Now laying out is Gallegos to keep it up for the Trojans. And this one is put through by Acosta, scrambling to punch it forward and finds the dead zone for a Trojan score. TIU outlasting the Titans there, and boy, that was impressive on that sequence. A couple of escapes by TIU when the odds were stacked against them to keep that thing from hitting the ground. Now Pusaono back into serve. She had a great stretch earlier in the match in set number two. Several consecutive points in the service effort. Now this one, palms up dig by Torres. Now floating in there, almost a Michael Jordan-esque layup looking effort from Acosta, but she manages to get it over. This one shoved forward. Vanderort all over the place, managing to keep it up, and this one does find the line. The Trojans gambling that it would have too much juice on it, but that was not the case here, so IUSB scoring. And they're just 3 points away from claiming the set. The Trojans needing to dig deep here. Jalen Freeman checking back in for TIU. The big three all out there, Freeman, Scripshock, and Torres. They'll turn to the veterans, as well as the pair of freshmen, Romero and Acosta. Here's Torres firing away. Now having a go at it is Jacobs, and she'll record the kill. So IUSB creeping dangerously close to that set point. And a potential 2-1 set advantage. Coach Ward still has a timeout here, electing not to use it. Trusting his veteran squad to stay the course as the Trojans do so here. Still facing a daunting 6-point deficit, with just 2 Titan scores necessary to send them to a win in set number 3. The veteran Scripshock with that low line drive serve this time. Now this one slapped out in front. It's around the net. Which side will it come down on? It is tapped over by IUSB. And the Trojans unable to do much about that. That really was just a question of which side it would come down on and which team was going to be able to batter it down. And actually, I believe they're going to say the point to the Trojans there. Couldn't quite see that, but we'll certainly take it. Though that one there, IUSB striking back. But this one finding the ground in front of a diving Freeman. So the Titans do manage to get it to set point. A daunting task for the Trojans. They need 6 consecutive. Here is Jacobs. The dig by Torres. Scripshock to Wheeler, and Wheeler unable to climb the net on this occasion. We've seen her come up short a couple of times when trying to go softer on it.
No, yeah, it's best of 5. Best of 5. It's 2-1 to them. So I would say 1-2.
So these Titans providing a real challenge for the Trojans here. As TIU is seeking to prevent their second loss in 3 matches and instead claim their 2nd consecutive victory. A very important conference match, especially considering it's against a team that is not considered one of the thoroughbreds in conference play, at least this season. Though their play this evening would suggest otherwise, and their conference record of 3-2 so far is quite solid. They've played some very good competition that's gotten them to that 5-11 mark on the season. And it certainly can be deceiving. The Trojans leave no such deception with their record, a sparkling 13-3 so far. Any team with a 13-3 record is fantastic, of course. But the Trojans have done it against some top-tier competition as well, facing some very strong teams inside and outside of the conference, traveling to various tournaments. Of course, the season-opening tournament that they co-hosted along with Trinity Christian, a fellow conference opponent. So the Trojans have really been all over the map, traveling across the country for some of these matchups. And just about wherever they've played, whether it's at Van Dixhorn, somewhere close by, or far abroad, they have brought a quality product to the court each and every time. But there's no doubt that the Titans of IUSB are doing the same thing tonight. And that's why those Titans have got a 2-1 set advantage against this red-hot Trojan squad. The Trojans on the season, they've now won 8 of their last 9. And 13 of their last 15. Seeking to keep up that terrific form with a victory here. They're going to have to win the last 2 sets to do it. So the focus here shifting from gaining the advantage in set number 3 to now finding some way to just get this to that winner-take-all set number 5. Once you get it to that point, anything can happen. So the Trojans will take it one set at a time. Should they claim set number 4, it's all going to come down to that deciding tiebreaker to 15. The Trojans marching back out there for this elimination set number 4. It's a must win, gotta have it for TIU. The Trojans certainly not intimidated or showing any less energy here, despite having their backs to the wall, going through some of their preset rituals. Smiles on the faces of many of the Trojan players as they are undaunted and certainly not intimidated by the opportunity. They've been here before. An interesting contingent out there for the Trojans. They have both of the freshmen, Acosta and Romero, along with the veteran Skripchak, Vujošević, the libero Freeman, and their standout hitter Torres. Skripchak will set up Acosta, who tried to take something off there, but a little too much off, as it wasn't enough to gain clearance over the net. So South Bend will claim the first point of set 4. Now this one clobbered down the middle, a diving effort to salvage it from Freeman. But the third strike to try to loft it back down to the Titans. Not quite forceful enough from Skripchak. A great effort by Freeman, though, to just keep that thing off the ground for the moment. And this one too far from Amber Jacobs. So the service error, making it just 2-1. Vujošević looking for the equalizer. The senior hailing from Montenegro, a transfer from rival Governor State University. Now this one put down, blocked in front, but errantly so. So Alexis Hassett recording the kill. As IUSB keeping their foot to the gas here, they're not going to make it easy on the Trojans. Now here is Campanello. Dug up easily by Freeman. Torres firing away. and it takes a deflection and springs up almost into the top row of those bleachers. Boy, there are some tall tales about the power of Brianna Torres, but that really just happened. That thing is about four rows down from the bottom of the seats, and that didn't even seem to be one of her hardest strikes. Dig by Vujošević. Now firing away on the opposite side, Acosta. Here's a set having a go. Great effort by Torres to keep it up, but Freeman's second effort is going to float behind the Trojan bench. I believe a couple of Trojans were converging upon it. Sometimes when you're scrambling in an instance like that, communication is very difficult to uphold. Now this one down the middle. Vujošević, diving effort by Skripchak, and Torres will put it over. Out in front, and I think that was into the net, and yes, indeed, the official will make the call. Substitutions for the Trojans. Here comes Gallegos once again. The excellent server for Trinity, and she makes her impact felt right there as that one was very difficult to corral. Now Torres trying to loft it over. Out in front, good save by Williams. Here comes Torres, a great dig by Vanderord, and now laying out Vujošević and Williams, and they combine to get it back over. A great effort by the Trojans, but it eventually does hit the floor. Nonetheless, some terrific acrobatics from TIU. But the point in the hands of the Titans, as is the serve. Vujošević with the give and go, trying to find the middle. Vanderort once again laying out. And South Bend keeping it alive. Now out of sync are Skripchak and Madison Williams. Williams a lot of times likes that just quick launch and fire to try to catch the opponent by surprise, but it can be hard to set up sometimes because if you don't have it perfectly in sequence, she's not in the air for long, so it's going to be hard to make something out of it. Now Torres. And we say it time and time again, but when Torres gets the strike on the ball that she wants, and that front line isn't able to block it, it is pretty much game over for the opponent as it was there. Now Torres firing away on the serve. Vujošević with the dig. Back to Vujošević. She pushes it forward right onto the line. A brilliant move from Lena Vujošević as she took some power off that time to just punch it forward right on the green boundary. Perfectly placed from Lena there. Now this one finding the dead zone. Not sure who caught that for the Titans, but falling down and was still able to punch it through and just found a bit of unoccupied real estate. That's the name of the game, isn't it? Lofted over, Freeman to the rescue. Set back for Torres. Now scrambling is IUSB. Here's Torres, free to fire from deep, too far. So IUSB fired up on the road. Their goal is to salt this away in four, and they've come out with a lot of energy. Up 8-5 here. Vujošević slamming it and right on the line once more. So she is doing everything she can to will the Trojans back into this one as they now only trail by two with plenty of time remaining. Couple of substitutes for the Trojans. The freshman Romero back in, as is the service specialist Pasono. She hammers it down and records the ace. Just firing that low line drive is something that Desiree has done with regularity throughout her Trojan career. Another one of those seniors who's very capable in a variety of roles, but has really accepted where she can help this team. And now this one's blocked in front. It's Romero and Vujošević holding firm. And just like that, the IUSB advantage is washed away. It's 8-all. Osono twirling the volleyball and now striking it. That was ticketed for the sideline, but a nice dig there to keep it alive. Vujošević just managing to get it on down. Now a little push in front. Pasano laying out to keep it alive as Romero pushes it on down. Another diving dig. And the Trojans somehow get it back over. And now this one is wide, and the Trojans have scored it. Just absolutely unbelievable. Desiree Pasano, an escape artist out there, doing the impossible for the Trojans not once but twice to keep that thing off the ground. And they eventually wear down the Titans to take the lead. And now this one not clearing the net, so a fourth touch recorded and TIU up 10-8. With their backs to the wall and a must-win set for the Trojans have just rattled off five consecutive scores. Osono bashes it down again. Now this one blocked out in front. The Titans keeping it alive for the moment. Vanderort seeing it over. Skripshock and Gallegos. And now here's Torres looking for the dead zone. But a good dig by Powell. This one hammered and now tapped over. And it really just caught a perfect deflection for IUSB as that was a gimme to just tap down into the hardwood. A great effort by TIU. And they still maintain a 1-point lead. Here is Powell. Dig by the versatile Torres. Now this one slammed down by Vujošević and she records the kill. So the diversified Trojan attack on display. Lena, one of the many Trojans recording consistent kills along with Romero, Acosta, Wheeler, and of course Torres, Madison, Williams, so many contributors on this Trojan squad. Here's the effort out in front and right on the line. So IUSB is hanging in it despite the Trojan surge. Now a no jump serve there from Amber Jacobs. Freeman finding a way to keep it alive. Here's the attempt out wide and a nice lunging dig by Romero. Now put back over by Acosta. Here comes his set. And the dig, the one-handed dig, unsuccessful from Torres. So it is 11s across the board, all tied up in set number 4. Freeman with the dig, leading Skripshock, who in turn leads Vujošević. And now the dig is an errant one, and the Trojans have the lead again. TIU out in front. Lena Vujošević. Always the opening server for the Trojans. Putting it over. Here's a deep strike. Nice dig by Skripshock. Now the effort from Vujošević. That one's dug out. Vanderort hustling, but that one into the official's space in the side of the net. And so the Trojans taking advantage to take a 2-point lead. It It's win or bust for TIU in set number four. Trailing two sets to one. This one taking a deflection and finding its way into the vacated space. So IUSB once again striking back. Both of these teams have not let the other get much breathing room, hardly at all evening long. Set number three was the only one where we saw IUSB really pull away for a prolonged period of time. The other sets have been neck and neck really the whole way. Here's Torres pushing it forward, dig by Powell. Now here's the attempt out wide. And there had to be too many touches there from the Titans as they were unable to work it over. So TIU just continuing to maintain that slim lead here. It is Jalen Freeman. The libero back to serve it. She rises and fires. Again, scrambling just to get it back over as IUSB. Skripchak setting up Torres. She's denied in front. What an effort by Skripchak and Williams. And Torres lofts it on back down. The Trojans keeping it alive. Now Skripchak rising up for another impressive dig. Here goes Acosta and just missed that back corner. And just barely missing the corner was Acosta. A terrific effort. But unfortunately, a couple of inches there, rendering a terrific play meaningless for the Trojans. Great effort all around on that occasion. Now here's Torres as the Trojans improvise and get it over again. Great dig by Freeman, but nobody home to salvage it. That was a great effort on an absolute bullet of a shot. That was coming straight for her. Some self-preservation, but in a very skilled way. But all for naught as it's 14-all. Skripchak setting up Acosta. She'll shovel it forward, and the Trojans score it. A nice mid-air adjustment from Isabella Acosta, as she wasn't going to be in sequence enough to hammer it down, but just able to punch it over and create chaos on the Titan side. So the Trojans out to the lead. 15-14, here's Emma Gallegos, and this one into the net. So that's part of the risk when you hammer that low serve that Gallegos does, sometimes prone to some errors, but it also reaps terrific rewards a lot of the time. Deadlocked at 15 in set number four. Williams has it with ease. Here's Torres, and blocked but wide of that green line. So Torres does record the kill and gives the Trojans once again just a very slim lead here. Would love to see a little bit of breathing room for TIU, but it has been hard to come by for both teams all evening long. Torres the dig here. Skripchak setting up Williams. She'll just punch it over. And this one clobbered into the wall. The Trojans denying it. Vanderort, Gallegos now with it. Here's Williams off the Skripchak set. She's rappelled in front. IUSB has a lot of players with a lot of height that provide an imposing presence in the middle. And it's thrown the Trojans for a loop on a couple occasions today, though they've still managed to have several solid kills on the evening. Here's Vujošević going right at that wall and just slamming it through the block. The Trojans once again with the lead. Now Pasoono checking in again. To do what she does best, and that's serve it up. She'll hit a laser here. IUSB does recover. Now Pasoono with the dig. Skripchak setting up Vujošević. Nice dig by Vanderort, but out in front. Vanderort denying Romero again. Off the rafters, that was ticketed for over the net, but somehow bounding back to the Titans. And some good fortune there for IU South Bend, as it was a really impressive second consecutive dig for Vanderort, but it went up into the ceiling and bounced off of one of those ceiling boards that runs across the roof here and back to their side, so they were able to get a more potent strike that won them the point. Now here's Vanderort having to set it back. Nice dig by Gallegos. Strip shot with a long range set, and Torres with the attempt. Romero with the quick reflexes to get it back over. Here's the effort from Jacobs. Torres digging it. Here's Vujošević. She's been very solid late. Another IUSB effort. Caroming harmlessly. And now Scripshock with the little punch, but another diving dig by Vanderort. Now Vujošević and Vanderort cannot get to this one, sending Gessinger into the seats, but she's unable to grab it. So too much juice on it that time as the Trojans finally record a point there. Anna Skripchak back to serve. We'll see if she goes with the loft, and she will this time. Now out in front, there's Jacobs. This one hooked wide, so another Trojan score. And the Trojans have led by 0-1 or 2 for what feels like the majority of this set. Skripchak lofting it up again. Here is Jacobs lunging to get it as Skripchak. And now Acosta standing will put it over. Now this one blocked by the Trojans out in front, and they record the score. It's that pair of talented freshmen, Isabella Acosta and Teresa Romero, holding firm. Timeout IUSB. So TIU with that never say die mentality that has led them to their impressive 13-3 start this year is rallying when they need to most. When this team has got their backs to the wall, which isn't an instance you see all that often, given how effective they've been this year, they really kick it into another gear. It's really been a fun time to be a Trojan fan in general. A lot of the Trojan teams have been fantastic this fall. It's been just a lot of fun. This volleyball team, 13-3 on the year, of course, but men's soccer enjoying a resurgent campaign. They are 6-1 right now. They've won 6 games in a row. One of the best starts in program history, and already doubling their win total from last season. The women's soccer team and the football team not having as good of results in terms of the records, but they faced some quality competition and have certainly shown a lot of promise against some quality teams this year. Skripchak lobbing it over. Nice dig by Torres. Here goes Vujošević back to the Trojans. Skripchak will set up Acosta. She'll have a go. Powell able to get to it. And they put it over. Nice side winding dig from Torres, and the Trojans recover it. Now lunging to get a piece of it is Gessinger. The block from the Trojans is errant, and Skripchak unable to catch up with it down the sideline. So a pivotal score for the Titans on a well-played point from both sides. Here is Amber Jacobs. She's been one of the primary killers for IUSB this evening. Skripchak flipping it to the side to set up Vujošević. Now here is Campanello laying out his script shock to keep it alive. Torres lofting it back down. Another hard go, but it is repelled by that wall of freshmen. Once again, Romero recording the block there. And those two freshmen playing with a ton of passion, showing a lot of emotion there. You've got to love the energy as well as the performance that those two bring to the table right from the get-go in their collegiate careers. Now this one mishandled off the service, A rare miscue from Vander Orden. And the Trojans will take it, and they'll also take a four-point lead. Vujošević. Trying to keep the momentum rolling for TIU. Here's the effort, and it's stuffed once again. This time it's Torres and Romero linking up. The veteran and the rookie forming an impenetrable barrier once again. And TIU out to a five-point lead in set number four. Timeout, Titans. What a surge from TIU. Just love to see the resilience from this Trojan squad. With their backs to the wall against a team that most expected them to beat fairly convincingly. Though these Titans have certainly come to play, and I think they're a better team than the record gives them credit for. But the Trojans didn't let that fear set in. And they've taken the bull by the horns here late in set number three to finally establish a pretty solid lead. Going up 23-18. They'll try to put it away right here and now. Vujošević will serve it up for TIU. She rises and fires. Dig off to the side by Vander Orden. Put over. Nice effort by Skripchak. Now Vujošević firing from deep. Not corralled cleanly and not a very potent attack that will be shoveled back down. Here comes Torres, and that one too hot to handle for Powell. So the Trojans just 1 point away from sending this to a decisive tiebreaker set number five. Lena Vujošević will try to finish it right here and now. Set point TIU. Vander Orden the dig. Powell shoving it forward for a set. But Freeman with the answer. Skripchak setting up Torres, and she's rejected out in front. It's hard to consistently stop the onslaught of Brianna Torres, but this IUSB front has done about as good a job as you could really ask. They've been able to mitigate her somewhat. But it's impossible to take her out of the game completely. She's still brought her A game tonight. Now this one put over by Romero. Issette will have a go. Freeman handles it calmly. Here's Torres, back to the Trojans. Skripchak now setting up Acosta, back to TIU again. Great reflexes from Skripchak and Acosta, but a violation recorded. I believe Acosta touched it with both hands and not in conjunction with each other, so that'll be the call. So set point number three for TIU, looking to finish things. Torres with the dig. Skripchak, a back set. But not too much on it from Acosta. Now nice dig by Freeman. Little too much juice on it, and they're unable to work it back over as it careens into the net. Skripchak and Romero did all they could to get that thing back over to the Titan side, but unable to do so. So IUSB is showing what they're made of here. Providing some resistance as they've scored the last three. Trojans still up by three. Their fourth set point. Here goes Torres, and she puts it away. So the Trojans looking to the veteran Torres.
Yes.
And she answers the call, and we are going to a winner-take-all set number five. So just when it seemed like things were going to get out of hand the slightest bit, who do you look to but the veteran standout, Brianna Torres? She's pretty much done it all in this game. three times all-region, three times first-team all-conference, four times all-conference in total, and no doubt on her way to another nod, probably in both of those areas this season. A third-team All-American a couple of seasons ago, and somebody that's, after all that she's done, possibly putting up her best season, her magnum opus this time around, as she has been outstanding as the leader of this Trojan attack. But it's a very diverse Trojan attack. So many skilled players that have contributed to the cause throughout the season, and perhaps chief among them are the pair of standout freshmen, Teresa Romero and Isabella Acosta. We've seen both figure prominently into this one today. A couple of terrific blocks from that duo that really helped TIU on their way to the victory in that winner-take-all set number four. But that's all over now. However we got here is irrelevant, because it is 2-2, and the first team to 15 is going to walk out of Ann Dixhorn Arena a winner tonight. It's a high-stakes clash in conference. IUSB 3-2 in conference, and a team that's looking to keep pace with some of the thoroughbreds, as is TIU, who is in pursuit of their first conference title since 2006. And has a great squad that is very capable of doing it. They've only lost one conference match in their opener in conference against the Fighting Bees of St. Ambrose, but they can ill afford another defeat early on here if they are to come away with that honor that has eluded them for a very long time. Well, there's the horn, and here we go. Set number five, just about to get going. It's winner take all in Van Dixhorn tonight. The Trojans with the majority of their starting lineup out there, but they're going to stick with Acosta once again, as she has just had a really impressive night and continuing to earn herself more and more playing time, even at a deep position for the Trojans, finding a way to contribute in a big way. And on a night like this, where the starter Nadia Wheeler hasn't had her best stuff after impressive play in the early going, she struggled a little bit on some of her strikes. It doesn't really matter when there's not going to be a significant decline in performance, and you can turn to another extremely talented player. Wheeler will no doubt get it right, as she has time and again. A terrific player for TIU, but so is Acosta. And she has been the woman of the hour, so to speak, for TIU, as this one slammed in there, and the Trojans out in front, setting the tone right from the get-go. And now chance of she's a freshman from the Trojan bench. Very supportive of their talented youngsters, as this one short from Vujošević. So it is one up in the decisive set. But that's something you love about this Trojan squad. You're not going to ever see anybody sulking or complaining about playing time. Everybody is fit into their niche and just supported all of their teammates, regardless of the fact that some of those teammates and their prowess might be eating into other talented players' opportunity. This time, IUSB recording it, as the Trojans unable to work it back over. So 2-1, the Titans in front. As high as the energy's been at some junctures tonight, it has never been higher than this. Here's Torres firing away and sliced it a little too far. Just barely misfiring, Brianna Torres. And it's 3-1, the Titans. The Trojans making noise between every single one of these plays. Now here's Vujošević, and she slams it into the wall and through it. A couple of times we have seen Vujošević just say, all right, you guys have got some talented players up front. Well, it's going to be my best against your best and see if you can handle it. And very rarely has IUSB been able to when she gets behind it. And now this one mishandled by Alexis is set, and we are all knotted up at three. So a miscue there, and in a blink of an eye, the Trojans right back in it. Now rising and firing, the veteran Freeman. Toward the side and out of sync is set here. Looked like she was going to jump and hit it, but instead had to wait back and try to strike it from the ground and couldn't get enough on it. So the Trojans out in front, 4-3. Freeman once more with a little bit of loft on this one, varying her looks. Now this one into the Trojan wall, the Titans recovering. They'll have to just lob it over to TIU. Acosta, strip shot, setting up Torres! And we've seen this movie before, Brianna Torres taking over late for TIU. 5-3, the Trojan advantage. They've rattled off four consecutive scores. A dig by Vanderort. Now out in front is Alexis Joyner, but the Trojans fend it off. Now scrambling are the Titans to try to recoup after the Torres strike. Vujošević laying out, and the Trojans recover on that one. Is that on the line? No, it is just barely wide on the effort from Jalen Freeman. Wow, a sensational diving effort from Lena Vujošević. She is always all over the place for the Trojans. Gives terrific effort from start to finish, and great effort here deep in the fifth set. But the Trojans unable to score. Now here's Torres, partially blocked, out in front, and through the block. And just a little too far to be handled by Freeman was that Titan strike, so we're knotted up. 5-5 in set number five. Sydney Hanna ready to serve it for IUSB. Vujošević digs it up easily. Now the give and go to Lena, and it's dug out by Vanderort. This one lobbed over into the chest of Williams, who's unable to handle it with one touch as it got it a little too deep towards her. So now IUSB taking the Trojans' punch and countering with one of their own. They lead at 6-5 now. The Trojans will look to flip the momentum again. Here is Williams a little bit out of sequence on the effort from Skripshock. We've seen that a couple times from Madison, who likes to just rise up very slightly, and it's a very potent strike, but if you're a little bit out of sequence, it is tough to convert on. Now here's Torres, diving effort to keep it up by Jacobs into the Trojan wall, and they recover. Skripshock, Vujošević over the middle. It's dug up again. Now down the sideline, and it is perfectly struck there. An absolute wallop, and IUSB has an 8-5 advantage in the decisive set number five. The two sides switching sides.
Because set number five, they've each been on one side for two sets.
So we saw the Trojans score on four consecutive efforts. Now IUSB countering by scoring on five in a row. It's a game of streaks and runs, and we'll see if the Trojans can get momentum back on their side right here. Vujošević laying out for the dig. Torres works it back over. Now this one punched over and somehow kept up by TIU. That thing seemed ticketed for the earth, but this one eventually does hit the ground, perhaps a bit of good fortune as this one catching a little hop off the net that directed it right into the left corner. The IUSB bench going crazy, but the Trojans have lost no energy as well. But they will call a timeout. A string of six consecutive points for IUSB has the Trojans on the ropes here. We'll see what they come out of the timeout with. Well, folks, this is what the CCAC is all about. Just terrific teams from top to bottom in this conference in so many different sports. It's very rare to think that you can predict the outcome of a CCAC match before it happens. As a team like IUSB, that their overall record this year isn't terrific, is showing that they're a heck of a lot better than that 5-11 mark indicates tonight. And the Trojans, of course, continuing to battle. They've had a couple of miscues throughout the night, but they've also showed off a lot of what they can do. A great showcase for both sides. 9-5 in the decisive tiebreaker to 15. Vujošević. Now Skripchak setting up Torres just beyond the end line. So Torres just barely off the mark. And now here in this pivotal fifth set, some pivotal playing time for the transfer junior Halsey Keltner. She's not played much all night, but a lot of trust from Coach Ward looking to her in a key spot. She gets the touch here, trying to force it through. Now a nice block from TIU out in front. It was Keltner and Williams combining on that. Now Keltner checking back out after the successful score for Trinity, and here comes Emma Gallegos. A terrific server for TIU. We'll see if she can conjure up some magic. Too much on that. So a couple of the Trojan attempts here in set number five have been errant, but only by the slightest degree, and that was one of them. Swan lobbed over. Williams, Skripchak setting up Torres. Vanderort with the dig, but too far out in front, or at least it appeared, but Powell was able to just touch pass it over as it barely stayed on the Titan side. So now 12-6 in favor of IUSB, and it's a timeout called by the Trojans. So TIU is on their last leg here, perhaps. What can they do to fend off elimination here and find a big run late? That's exactly what Coach Ward and Coach Mang are talking about right now. But they're not even in the huddle right now, interestingly enough. This is entirely led by the players in this moment. The coaching staff showing a lot of trust in their veteran leadership right now. And that round table positivity we've seen up and down the roster. We will see if some of these Trojan players can find a way to inspire their teammates to dig deep and just find a way to get this thing back to even. South Bend, on the other hand, very fired up. Dancing, celebrating, they've been like that all night. But they're certainly in danger, perhaps, of forgetting the fact that the job is not, in fact, finished. A lot of positive energy from them. This one slammed down by Williams. Good dig, though. Now Vujošević unable to corral it cleanly. Good hustle by Freeman and Gallegos, but neither able to get there in time. So South Bend is just 2 points away from claiming the set and claiming the match. Whitney Gessinger back to serve it. This one barely climbing over the net. Now having a go is Mackenzie Powell. As that one, the dig attempt by Williams wandered over the net and Powell pinpoints it in the back corner. So it is match point for IUSB. The Trojans facing the daunting task. They need eight in a row. Here's Vujosevic trying to get the first of those. Powell puts it over. Vujosevic just managing to fist it over. Torres, good dig by Vanderort. Now here's the effort from Jacobs. Getting there is Gallegos. Vujosevic and Torres slamming it back on down. An extended point here. Jacobs with some loft. Williams recovering. Strip shot. Setting up Torres one more time. Vanderort with the answer. Jacobs slamming away. Good dig by Freeman. Strip shot. Setting up Williams. She slipped but still manages to get it over. Freeman with the dig with her palms up. Now Torres slamming away. And Torres with the finish to keep Trinity alive. Boy, the tension was mounting for that entire sequence. And so impressive with TIU with their backs to the wall, knowing that any errant touch could be their last, finding a way to score it. And Brianna Torres, the veteran standout, the all-world outside hitter, finding a way to keep it alive. Now Torres in the service. Here's a nice dig by Gallegos toward the net, and it is stuffed down in front and down on the Trojan side, and that is going to conclude matters here in this one. In what was a terrific, hard-fought contest between these two conference powerhouses, the IUSB Titans emerge victorious. So a rare loss for the Trojans. They will fall to 13-4 on the campaign. A minor setback in what's been an extremely impressive season for these Trojans, and they showed their fight tonight. It was a great effort from this team, no doubt about it. But ultimately,